They were all together in one place, in an upper room, praying for God's power from on high. They were waiting for a promise made not so long ago. Jesus said that he'll set their souls on fire. Suddenly a sound wind came rushing in, and their souls were set aflame. To them he gave the power to call upon his name. Suddenly I can feel his mighty power. Suddenly I can feel the change within, and I know that I would never, never be the same again. You will find what you need at the altar. Leave behind every way that presses in for the Spirit of the Lord is still moving. Suddenly. Never let your heart become troubled. There's no need to be afraid. The devil will assume you don't have strength to carry on. There is glory in God's presence. There's healing in God's word. He's our anchor and our priest in every storm. So my friend, call the Lord and you trust his word. Age to age he's still the same. He's a God that hears us and a God that loves us. There's power in God's name. Suddenly I can feel his mighty power. Suddenly, I can feel the change within, and I know that I would never, never be the same again. You will find what you need at the altar. Leave behind every way that presses in, for the Spirit of the Lord is still moving. For the Spirit of the Lord.
let's get down to the preaching tonight. Let's go to the screen. Our topic tonight is on the screen. What's our topic for tonight?
Choosing the fire.
Come on, everybody say, what's our topic tonight?
Choosing the fire.
Choosing the fire. Now, ladies and gentlemen, in the Bible, what did I say?
In the Bible.
Babylon is referred to as false religion.
Okay.
And in my studies, and you will know that I do a lot of that.
Yes.
Babylon is a religious system that opposes the gospel.
Oh, yes.
And the gospel is not that Jesus died on the cross and rose again. The gospel includes lifestyle.
Yes.
It includes health. Yes. Is anybody
yes,
here?
Yes, yes, yes.
And because she does, the Bible says that she is disintegrating. She is falling apart.
Yes, sir.
She is crumbling down.
Yes, yes.
The Bible says in Revelation chapter 14 and verse 8 that Babylon is what?
Fallen.
Come on, read that for me, please. Babylon is what?
Fallen.
And you notice, it's not just fallen, but it's fallen.
Yes, yes.
So it fell before and it's falling again.
Yes, yes, yes.
That great city, because she made all nations drink of the wine of the wrath of her fornication.
All right. Yes, yes.
And Babylon knows that she's fallen.
Yes.
Am I speaking the truth?
Yes, truth, truth.
I say Babylon knows that she's fallen.
Yes.
And in my life as a minister of the gospel, I have come to realize that Babylon is not invincible.
All right. Okay.
Did you hear me?
Yes.
Babylon is not a power in itself. Against the power of God, Babylon is myopic, and the Bible proves it.
Okay.
And the reason why God has not yet destroyed Babylon is because there are people in Babylon who are his people. Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen, amen.
And so tonight God shouts in Revelation chapter 18 and verse 4. What does it say here, please, everybody?
And I heard another voice.
Come on, everybody. Every single person. What does it say here, please?
And I heard another voice from heaven saying, come out of her, my people, that ye be not partakers of her sins, and that ye receive not of her plague.
So God says, come out of her.
Yes, sir.
That's a pronoun. That's a feminine pronoun. And ladies and gentlemen, woman in prophecy represents the church.
Yes, yes, yes.
And so God is saying, come out of this false system of worship.
Yes, yes, yes.
This system where the priests or the fathers are not getting married, when God says it is not good that a man should be alone.
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
This system where they say you can eat anything, just give thanksgiving. This system where they say that you can drink wine for the stomach's sake.
All right, all right.
God is calling you out.
Yes, sir.
God says, come out of her, and God identifies the people that he wants to come out. He says, come out of her.
My people. Yes. Yes, man.
If you are God's own tonight, you respond to the truth.
Yes, sir.
Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen, amen.
If you are God's own tonight, you'll stand up and you'll do what is right. Am I speaking the truth here?
Yes, yes, yes. The truth, man.
Come out of her, my people, that you be not partakers of our sins, and that you receive not of her plagues.
Yes, sir.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, if God tells you to come out of Babylon and you obey his voice, God has no choice but to protect you.
Yes, yes, true.
Come true, on, somebody true, talk true. To me here tonight.
True, true, true.
Maybe I should say that again.
Yeah.
If God tells you to come out of Babylon and you obey his voice, he has no choice but to protect you.
Yes, man. Yes, yes.
Shadrach, Meshach, and a bad Negro understood that. These guys defied the authority of a king who was filled with pride.
Yes, sir.
Nebuchadnezzar thought that he was in charge.
Yes, sir.
And there are some bosses across Trinidad who think that they are in charge. There are people here who want to keep God's Sabbath, but they are putting a job in front of them. But let me tell you something here tonight. God is not mocked. Any person who mocks God, God is going to fix you.
Yes, man. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, man. That's right. That's right.
Now, you will recall that Daniel interpreted a dream that Nebuchadnezzar had. Do you remember that?
Yes, yes, yes.
Mm-hmm. Now, the dream was given to him that he might understand. That he might what?
Understand.
The part he was to play in the world's history.
Yes, yes.
So God gave him a dream to tell him, listen, Nebuchadnezzar, you are only going to rule for a time.
Yes, sir.
But the years of prosperity that followed filled his heart with pride, and he forgot God, assuming his idol worship.
Oh, yes.
Friends, it is clear from scripture. It is clear from what?
Scripture.
That the wise men of Babylon were frustrated by Daniel and his friends.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
They didn't like them.
No, no, no.
They didn't like those boys who were just keeping God's commandments.
Yes, yes.
And there are people across Trinidad, man, they're like everybody else except Seventh-day Adventists. Am I speaking
true,
the truth?
True, yeah. Yes, man.
And some of us give them reason for not liking us because we are living double standard. We are preaching one thing and we are saying something
else. Yes, man. Yes. Yes, preacher.
Come but on. I keep telling you here night after night, don't put your eyes on people. Put your eyes on Jesus. Amen, come on, somebody amen, say amen.
Amen. Amen. Yes, man. Amen.
There's some of us in the church, we are getting married and divorced and married, divorced and married, like if we are playing. There's some of you here, you are married to somebody who in the sight of God is married to somebody else.
Yes, man. Yes.
Am I talking to anybody?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And so Daniel and his friends frustrated the Chaldeans.
Yes.
The priests. Because everything that happened, they're part of it. Nebuchadnezzar asks his wise men to interpret the dream. They can't do it, Mr. Magistrate. But here comes Daniel.
Yes, yes.
In addition to that, the diet that the guys chose in the eyes of the wise were inferior.
Oh, yes.
The wise men chose the cattle and the chicken. And the mutton. Is anybody listening to
yes,
me?
Yes, yes, yes.
The Bible says here. Put it here, please. The Bible says in Daniel 1:15. And at the end of the 10 days, they're what?
Countenances.
Those guys chose like watermelon and pomsite. Am I talking to anybody
yes,
here?
Yes, yes.
And kenop and papa. Those guys chose fruits and vegetables, but the wise men chose the meat and the chicken and the fish. And the Bible says, at the end of 10 days, their countenances appeared what?
In fairer.
Fairer. And what else?
Fatter.
Fatter in flesh than all the children which did eat the portion of the king's meat.
Yes.
That embarrassed them. They were embarrassed because they could not tell the king the dream.
Yes.
And Daniel did. And so watch it. Secretly, they began to plot revenge. Aye, aye, aye. Follow me here tonight.
Yes.
That's what Babylon does. And at the heart of their satanic scheme was the worship of God regulated by the state.
All right, all right.
And Nebuchadnezzar, who should have known better because of the vision he got. And let me tell you something. All of your pastors know better.
Yes, man. Yes, yes.
Every Sunday worshiper in Trinidad knows that Saturday is the Sabbath. Am I speaking
man,
the truth?
Yes, yes, yes. Yes, man.
Your pastors know better. I heard T.D. Jakes says, oh, he keeps the Sabbath. Every Saturday, he stays home and rests. That's not what the Bible says. The Bible says that when Saturday comes, you must go into the sanctuary, just as Jesus did.
Yes,
Jesus
man.
Went to church on the Sabbath.
Yes,
am I speaking
man.
The truth here?
Amen, amen. Yes, man. Truth, truth. Yes, man.
They don't want to lose their money. You listening?
Yeah.
But as pastors here, I tell you, we don't get money from your offering. Look, the treasurer there. He pays Brown and Colton, Alexis. They get a check every month. But these guys, they're hauling everything every Sunday.
Yes.
I think I was giving the folks a story. I heard it on the net. I know you'll laugh, but these three pastors got together. They say it was a Trinidadian, a Jamaican, and an American. They were discussing what they do with the money when they get it on Sunday. The American said that he puts it in a box, Pastor Roy. Shake the box. Closes his eyes. Cut it right down. What's on the left belongs to God. What on the right belongs to him. The Chinese say he doesn't do it like that. He goes out and throws it in the air. And he makes a big circle. What falls in the circle is his. What falls outside the circle belongs to God. Then the Jamaican say, well, I don't make a circle. I go outside, yes. And I throw it in the air. And what God wants, he better take. Because what come down here? These guys are just after money. Just after possession. Preaching a prosperity gospel. Am I speaking the truth here? Yes. But they are not preaching the truth in the world of the living God. Do I have a witness here?
Yes, yes, yes.
And the Bible says that if the blind lead the blind, both are going to fall in the ditch.
Yes, man, yes.
It's time for you to come out. Yes. Come out of error. I say, come out of error.
Yes,
God's
man.
Ten commandments are not nailed to any cross. God's ten commandments still stands. Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen, amen, amen. Amen. Yes, man. Amen. Hallelujah.
And so Nebuchadnezzar united with the wise men.
Yes.
They joined forces. And endeavor to make an image. A what?
An image.
That will represent Babylon as a kingdom that will last forever.
All right.
The Bible says, put it. Daniel chapter 3 and verse 1. What it says here, please, everybody.
Nebuchadnezzar the king made an image of gold, whose height was 3 cubits, and the breadth thereof 6 cubits. He set it up in the plain of Dura, in the province of Babylon.
I want you to note something. The king was advised to make a statue like the one he saw. And Nebuchadnezzar was not doing this thing on his own, bro. He was consulted. When he called the cabinet, when he called the executive committee meeting, the guys would say, why don't we make a statue just like the one you saw? But instead of making it with all the metals, let us make it entirely of gold. We want to show God that we're going to rule forever.
Yes.
Hear me, friends. Try as you may, no man can nullify the influence of God.
Oh, yes.
Next election God say UNC, it will be UNC. If next election God say PNM, it's going to be PNM. If next election God say CLP, Claudius Liberation Party, it will be that. What God wants, he gets.
Yes, sir.
Nobody. And write this down in your medulla oblongata. Nobody can nullify the significance of the image of Daniel 2.
All right.
What that image says will stand. Am I speaking
the
truth?
Yes, yes, yes.
Kings will come and kings will go.
Yes.
It was Eric Williams, but he gone. Not true?
Yes, yes.
And then you had Chambers, didn't you? And then you had the fellow from Tobago, the Honorable A&R Robinson. Then you had Pandey, Mr. Pandey. Now you have Mr. Manning. Oh, they come and go. Leaders come and leaders go. But God is the only leader that stays forever. Amen, come on, amen. Somebody shout amen.
Amen, amen. Amen.
You can't vote God out.
No. No
way. So kings will come and kings will go.
Yes, sir.
Prime ministers will come and prime ministers will go.
Yes.
Political parties will come and political parties will go. But put it here, my boy. But the purpose, plan, and will of God will be
accomplished.
Accomplished.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Amen. Amen.
But I want you to note something. Stay with me here. Help me, Jesus.
Yes.
Stay with me here. Watch this. By the height and beauty of the image, the king sought to make error and false doctrine magnificent and attractive.
Oh, yes.
I don't care how attractive your church is. If you are not keeping God's Ten Commandments, that is not a true church.
All right. Yes, yes.
You can have the best drums. You can have state-of-the-art equipment. You can have the best choirs. You can have dancers. You can have this. You can have things to feed the poor. You can have what you want. If you're not doing what God says, then it's a false church.
Yes, man. Yes, yes. Amen. Yes, man.
And I'm not here to please anybody.
No.
This is no time to water down any message. This is time to tell it like it is.
Yes, man. Yes, yes. Yes, sir.
Attractive as error looks, truth is truth.
Yes, yes. Yes, man.
And if Sabbath keeping is truth, then Sunday keeping is?
False. Yes. Yes, man.
Sunday's not a worship day. It's a work day.
Yes.
It's a day that God worked on. Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen, amen.
God worked on Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. But on Saturday, on the seventh day, he did not work.
Yes, man. Yes, yes. Amen.
He blessed it. Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen. Amen.
And he sanctified it. Come on, somebody say
yes,
amen.
Amen. Amen.
If baptism by immersion is true, then sprinkling and confirmation is false.
Yes, man. Yes.
You show me sprinkling here. Anybody can show me in the Bible where I'm going to sprinkle somebody. I'll give you $1,000 tonight. You show me confirmation here. And the falsehood hit you right in your face. But you're still in there. Oh, pastor, I am a server. Oh, pastor, I've been in it for this amount of years. God is calling you, man. God says, come out of her.
Yes, man. Yes, yes.
Come out of her.
Yes, sir.
That's why God has set up these crusades, not only here in Pleasantville, but in Point and in Chaguanas and all over Trinidad. God has set up these crusades to call his people out, to call the Indians and to call the Negroes, to call the Hindus and to call the Muslims, to call the Sunday worshiper. God says, come out of her.
Yes, man. Yes, yes. Amen.
It's time that you take a stand.
Yes, sir. Yes, man.
If when you speak in tongues, you must have an interpreter, then speaking in tongues without one is false.
All right.
Am I talking the truth here?
Yes, yes.
When you go to church, anybody who tell you, holla, 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 holla. And watch not lift them. When I attended the New Testament church, I'm talking about my history. They taught us to speak in tongues. They started slowly wrong to say, I tie your bow tie, you tie my bow tie. I tie your bow tie, you tie my, and then they go fast. I tie your bow tie, I tie your bow tie, you tie my bow tie, you tie. I tie your bow tie, you tie my bow tie. Speaking in an unknown tongue is not biblical. If you speak in an unknown tongue in church, Paul says, if you want to babble, if you want to speak in an unknown tongue, you get in your house, in your bedroom, and you speak unto God, because God can read your thoughts. Am I speaking the truth
here? Amen, amen, amen. Yes, man.
These guys are fooling us. I say they are fooling us.
Yes, man.
When it comes to truth, it's not what you think. Truth is truth, regardless to how you feel.
Yes.
Even if it hurts you, it's truth.
Yes, sir.
And you can't fight the truth. Amen. Truth is like a cork. You push it right to the bottom of the tub, but when you let it go, it rises. Am I speaking the truth here?
Yes, man. Yes, sir. Yes.
Well, these religious men took their next step in the satanic scheme. They said, okay, build an image. That's fine. They induce him to make the worship of the image the established religion of the country. Stay with me here tonight. The Bible says in Daniel chapter 3 and verse 2. Come on, read it, please, everybody. Come on, everybody. What does it say here?
Then Nebuchadnezzar the king sent to gather together the
come
princes.
Come on, that's not everybody. Everybody, let's go again.
Then Nebuchadnezzar the king sent to gather together the princes, the governors, and the captains, the judges, the treasurers, the counselors, the sheriffs, and all the rulers of the provinces to come to the dedication of the image which Nebuchadnezzar the king had set up.
Fine, that's all right. That's all right. You can dedicate your image. That's not the problem. The problem is in this verse. Put it. Verse 6 says, and whoso falleth not down.
All right, all right.
That's the issue to their worship.
Yes.
Satan wants to be worshipped. Everything God says, Satan has a counterfeit.
Yes, yes, yes.
God says up, Satan says down.
Yes, yes.
God says Saturday, Satan says Sunday.
That's right.
God says baptism by immersion, Satan says sprinkling.
Yes.
God says marriage, Satan says what? Come on, Lord. God says that he's coming again in great power and glory. Satan says no, he's coming in some secret rapture.
Yes.
Satan always has a counterfeit. Is anybody listening to me?
Yes, yes, yes. Yes, man, tell us.
You don't have to go to any university to know what the counterfeit is. All you got to do is to search the word of the living God.
Amen,
come on,
amen,
put your hands
amen.
Together for the Bible, man.
Amen, amen. Yes, man.
And whoso falleth not down. What does that have to do with any dedication?
Yes.
You see their plan?
Yes.
The issue was worship.
Yes.
Whoso falleth not down in worship shall the same hour be cast in the midst of a burning
fiery furnace.
Why didn't he say, if you didn't worship, I go cut your salary in half?
Yes.
You.
Yes, yes. Yes, man.
And so watch it. To inaugurate the worship, the king assembled a great concourse of his subjects. They included the very echelon of his government. The Bible says, put it. There were the princes and what else?
The governors.
And who else?
Captain.
The judges, the treasurers, the counselors, the sheriffs and the rulers. Notice the poor people were not there.
Yes, man, yes.
Catch the picture, catch the picture.
Yes.
Put it, boy, put it. The degree to bow will not disturb an idolater. It was designed by these religious leaders to trap the Jew.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Talk to me. Talk to me. Yes, man.
The people of God.
Why can't I get my Sabbath off and work on Sunday?
Yes.
Can't you see it? You go for a job at Seventh-day Adventist. As soon as they hear you, Seventh-day Adventist. Am I speaking the truth?
Yes, man. Yes, yes.
People see the issue. Understand the issue. We wrestle not against flesh.
Yes, but.
That's right.
And so, the wise men planned. And they planned. You listening? In fact, they planned well, they thought. They had everything in place.
Yeah.
Not just the 90 feet image and a 50 feet pedestal, but the punishment was decreed. I love how the Message Bible says it. The Message Bible says, anyone who does not kneel and worship, not just worship, but you must what?
Kneel.
Shall be flown immediately into a roaring furnace.
Yes.
Just imagine the scene. Just imagine. Open your minds. Here is an idol. Shine. 90 feet tall. And Nebuchadnezzar sits right near to him. So as you bow to the idol, you bow to him.
Yes.
Just watch the scene here. All the big shots, the cabinet ministers, the Mannings and the Pandes and the Maraj. Is anybody here?
Yes.
Not the poor people. Because they're now attacking the Jews, you see? Because after Daniel interpreted the vision of Daniel chapter 2, they were promoted by Nebuchadnezzar. Is anybody listening to me?
Yes, yes.
The king sits on his throne. Everybody looks at the king. And at the same time, look at the image. There is nothing wrong looking, but there is something wrong bowing.
Yes.
Is anybody here?
Yes, yes.
The Chaldeans, watch it. The Chaldeans places spies at the back and at the side of the three Hebrew boys.
That's right.
Because everybody wants to bow.
Yes.
Therefore, how come they did see that the boys didn't bow? People are always spying.
Yes.
In St. Vincent, we call them Marco.
Yes.
Or we call them peeping Tom. They see people coming to Jesus. Instead of they come and give their life to Christ, they're spying.
Yes, yes, yes.
Away she going.
Yes.
Where he going? Let me tell you something. Never, never, never put your trust in princes. Never put your trust in people. Even your own family will let you down. Yes, but I know of somebody who will never let you down. Amen, His name is Jesus.
Amen, amen.
Come on, somebody say amen, man.
Amen. Amen. Yes, man.
Amen.
And the spies are looking. And the three Hebrew boys, their actions are being carefully monitored. You listening?
Yes, sir.
Some have their cell phones recording. And then with military precision and the sound of the warlike music, the king shouted, "Bow to your God, the golden image Babylon." But the guys, put it, did not bend.
Amen. Amen.
They stood tall.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
God is looking for men to stand up.
Hallelujah.
Like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
Yes,
that's
sir.
Why the psalmist says, "Clifton, blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. But his delight
is in the law of the Lord." Yes,
is in the law of the Lord.
Yes, sir. Yes,
and in
sir.
That law doth he meditate day. And the Bible says, "And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of waters that bringeth forth his fruit in his season." His leaf.
Yes,
oh, somebody
yes,
talk to
yes,
me.
Yes, yes.
His leaf also shall not wither. And whatsoever he doeth shall what? The ungodly are not so, but are like the chaff which the wind driveth away. Therefore, the ungodly shall not stand in the judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. But the Lord knoweth the way of the righteous, but the way of the ungodly.
Yes, man.
Shall perish.
Amen.
My desire here tonight
amen.
Is to do God's will.
Amen. Amen.
Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen.
If your desire here tonight is to do God's will, let me see your hands, please.
Yes, man. Hallelujah.
Oh, I want to do thy will. Oh God, know that song? I want to do thy will, oh Lord. Hear the song. Break me, make me, mold me, and fill me. I want to do thy will, oh Lord. Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen, amen.
And when you do the will of God, the Lord takes you from the bottom of the mountain and he puts you on the top of the
amen,
mountain.
Amen.
Well, when you do the will of God, man, the Lord walks with you.
Yes,
when you do
sir.
The will of God, the Lord bless you
yes,
in
sir.
Your school exams. The Lord bless. Am I speaking the truth?
Yes, 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 yes. Yes, man, the truth.
The guys would not bend. When the Chaldeans, when the who?
Chaldeans.
Who are the priests? Saw that the guys would not join in their song or bend their knees. They went to Nebuchadnezzar and charged them with a threefold count of disobedience.
All right.
Put it. Daniel 3:12. There are certain Jews. They went to the king.
Yes.
Nebuchadnezzar did not see the guys in the bow. There were so many people. They went to the king. There are certain Jews. Jealous. Whom thou hast set over the affairs of the province of Babylon, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. These men, O king, have not what?
Regarded thee.
Number one, they serve not thy
gods.
No, worship the golden image.
Oh, yes.
A Seventh-day Adventist, we got to learn to stand up.
Yes, yes.
Don't walk on God's Sabbath. You hear me?
Yes, man.
Stand up, man.
Yes, yes.
God will never leave you. I say, you stand up.
Yes, sir.
You tell the boss, you keep your job. God will take care of me.
Amen.
I take a look and hear somebody say, "Seek ye first the kingdom of God
yes.
and all his righteousness. And all these things shall be." Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen, amen, amen. Amen.
God never fails. I say he never fails.
Amen, amen.
Now Nebuchadnezzar did not order their immediate persecution, but summoned them to him. He did not throw them in the fire immediately.
All right.
But he called them because he knew who he was dealing with.
Yes, yes, yes.
You don't touch the man of God. You hear me?
Yeah.
I see. Are you listening to me? They knew. He knew who he was dealing with. The Bible says in Daniel 3:14. Let's read, please, everybody. What it says?
Nebuchadnezzar spake and said unto them, Is it true, O Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, do not ye serve my gods, nor worship the golden image which I have set up?
So he called them in, put them to sit down. Is it true?
Yes, sir.
Which means that he didn't know. He was told so by the Chaldeans.
Yes.
The record states that at this point, the guys did not speak.
All right.
And so, with hands outstretched in upward defiance, Nebuchadnezzar makes another mistake. Here the mistake. Put it. Daniel chapter 3 and verse 15. Come on, everybody read it here, please.
Now if ye be ready.
Come on, everybody. What it says?
Now if ye be ready, that at what time ye hear the sound of the cornet.
Yes, please.
Flute, harp, sackbut, psaltery, and dulcimer, and all kinds of music, ye fall down and worship the image which I have made.
Well, next slide, please. But
if ye worship not, ye shall be cast the same hour into the midst of a burning fiery furnace.
And look at his mistake. Look at his mistake. Put it. His mistake is this. And who is that God?
All right. All right. Oh, yes.
Who is that God
Oh, yes.
That shall deliver you out of my hands?
All right.
So Nebuchadnezzar said, we are going to play the music again, and I will be looking this time.
Yes, sir.
The guy has a bad memory. I say he has a bad memory.
Yes.
He forgot the statement he made just a few months ago in the presence of Daniel. This is what he said. Put the thing here. Nebuchadnezzar said, the king answered unto Daniel and said, of a truth, it is that your God is a God of gods.
Yes, man. Yes, man.
No, he threatens God.
Yes.
He defies the power of God.
Yes.
He is defied by three worshippers of God, and now he defies their God.
Yes, true, true.
But with the flames in sight, their hearts rang with the promise. When thou passest through the waters.
Yes.
Come on, somebody talk to me here.
Yes.
Isaiah chapter 43 and verse 2. When thou passest through the waters, I will be with thee.
Yes.
And through the what?
The rivers.
They shall not overflow thee. When thou walkest through the what? The
fire.
Thou shalt not be burned.
Amen.
Neither shall the flame. Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen, amen, amen. Amen. Yes, man, yes.
In fact, this is what I love about this story. Hear what the guy said. Nebuchadnezzar, what is your problem? We are not careful to answer thee in this matter.
All right.
I love that, you know. Keep your job. I am not breaking God's out.
Yes, man. Yes, amen.
Keep your ring. I'm not giving you any other.
Amen, amen.
We got to learn to stand up.
Yes, sir.
They said, we are not careful to answer thee in this matter. They say in verse 17, if it be so, our God whom we serve is what?
Able to deliver.
From the burning fiery furnace, and he will deliver us.
Yes, man, out of thy hand.
In fact, they said after, even if he does not deliver us, we would not bow down.
Yes, man, yes. Amen, amen.
The boys were ready to die. They were willing to give their lives to their conviction.
Yes, man.
Ladies and gentlemen, if nothing is ever true, it is this. True Christian principle does not stop to weigh the consequences.
Yes, man. That's right. That's right.
Come on, somebody say
that's
amen.
That's right. That's right.
Come
amen,
on, everybody
amen.
Should read this. What it says, please. Everybody. What it says here?
True Christian principle does not stop to weigh the consequences. Amen, amen.
So when it comes to matters of the heart, it is not what people think.
Yes.
It is not what my parents say.
All
it
right.
is not what my friends dictate. It is what I believe.
Yes,
it is
man.
What I am willing to die for.
Yes, 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 man, yes. The word of God, man, yes. Amen, amen.
And so Nebuchadnezzar say, all right, you guys bad? Heat up the fire. Seven times hotter. But while he sat on his throne, there was another king on another throne.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
God knew that the fire was hot.
Yes, sir.
I heard somebody say that God called a cherubim.
Yes,
and
sir.
God said to the cherubim, cherubim, my sons are in trouble. How long will it take you to get down to planet Earth? The cherubim said 30 seconds. God said, that's too slow. Then he called the seraphims and he said to the seraphims, how long will it take you to get down to planet Earth? My boys are in trouble. And the seraphim said, 15 seconds. God said, too slow. Yes. Then he called on Jesus.
Amen, amen.
I said, then he called on Jesus.
Amen.
The lily of the valley.
Yes, sir.
The bright and the morning
yes,
star.
Sir. Yes,
he
sir.
Called once. Jesus did not answer. He called a second time. Jesus did not answer. And when he called a third time, Jesus answered. Jesus said, Father, I'm in the furnace already.
Yes, sir. Amen, amen. Amen.
Man, before you call, he's going to answer. I heard one preacher say, faster than the inconceivable velocity
yes.
of sound or sight,
yes, sir.
Jesus left heaven.
Yes, sir.
And when he landed in the furnace, it was like air conditioning.
All right, all right. Amen, amen. Yes, man.
In fact, the guys were walking up and down in the fire. Walking up and down in the fire. They were singing Clifton. "'Tis so sweet to trust in Jesus, just to take him. Oh, just to rest upon his promise, just to know the
Lord, Jesus, Jesus, how I trust him, how I prove
him more and more. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, hope for grace. To trust him all. Come on, somebody say amen. Come on, somebody
amen,
say amen.
Amen, amen.
Come on, put your hands together for Jesus.
Amen,
somebody.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
You got to learn to stand up, man.
Yes, man, stand up.
You got to stand up for what you believe.
Yes.
If you believe Saturday is the Sabbath, man, you might have been a Sunday worshiper for 40 years. Stand up.
Yes, man, yes.
Stand up.
Oh, yeah.
When you stand up for Jesus, he stands up for you. Come
amen,
on, somebody
amen,
say amen.
Amen.
Come on,
amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
I baptized in Dominica in 96. Well, 96, I think. No, she was 92. Well, in the 90s. She was a Catholic for all her life. Came to my tent. And she heard about the Sabbath.
Yes.
She said, Pastor, never heard about these things. My wife was there. My wife saw her. When on that Sabbath when we baptized her, we honored her. She was baptized all by herself. Went back to Dominica last year for training and meetings, and I saw her, and she's still strong.
Yes, man. Praise
when
the Lord.
When she saw me, her face was lighted up.
Praise the Lord.
Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen, amen.
You got to learn to stand up.
Yes,
when you
man.
Stand up for God, God stands up for
amen,
you, man.
Amen.
Let me tell you something. You can never lose serving Jesus.
No, no, no.
If the devil take it from the left, God will put it in the right. Come
yes,
on,
man.
Say amen.
Yes, yes, yes. Yes, man. Yes, yes.
Amen. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were flown in the fire.
Yes, sir.
But they didn't bend. They didn't bow.
No.
And so they didn't burn.
No, no, no.
Put it, put it, put it, put it. They did not burn because God is
able.
Put
yes,
it.
Man.
They did not burn because Jesus
walked in the fire. Yes, man, yes.
In fact, Nebuchadnezzar got crazy.
Yes.
He said, but wait. Did we not cast three men in the fire? He said, please bring my spectacles. Bring me my bifocals. But how come I see four?
Ah, yes.
And the fourth, look. Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen, amen, amen.
He said the fourth looked like the Son of God.
Amen.
Oh, they did not burn because Jesus walked in the fire. And put the next one here, please. They did not burn because they fought fire with
faith. Yes, man. Amen. Yes, man.
The God whom they serve is able.
Yes, man.
Is able. And watch it. Shh, shh, shh. If you miss anything tonight, don't miss this. Shh. Watch it. Wake up. Put it. God did not protect them from the fire, but he protected them
in the fire. Yes, man. Yes, man.
Maybe I need to say it again. Put
yes,
it. Put
yes,
it. What
yes.
it says here? God did not protect them
from the fire.
But he protected them where?
In the fire. Yes, man. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Yes, man.
The message of Daniel 3 is clear. God is in control.
Yes, man.
even during crises.
Yes, yes, yes.
Oh, in times like these, you need a savior. Mr. Treasurer, in times like these, Pastor Bro, you need
an anchor.
Be very sure. Sister Beverly, you know what I mean? Be very sure.
I want you to sing it.
Your anchor hold, Alexis. And grips the solid
rock.
I heard somebody say,
this rock is Jesus.
Yes, he's the one. Come on, sing it.
This rock is Jesus.
The only one. Be very sure.
Come on, sing it, son.
Be very sure. Your anchor holds and grips the solid rock.
Come on, put your hands together for Jesus, somebody.
Amen.
Come on, put your hands together for Jesus.
Hallelujah,
somebody.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Yes, man. Glory to God.
He didn't save them from the fire. But he saved them where?
In the fire.
Come on, turn and tell somebody that. He didn't save them from the fire. But he saved them where?
In the fire.
When you come into Jesus, you got to learn to take some fire.
Yes, man. Yes, yes.
Some of you want everything to be easy. You got to learn to take some
fire. Yes, man.
Is anybody here?
Yes, man.
My wife was a Pentecostal. She took some fire. She was New Testament. Took fire. I was Adventist at the time. When the mother see that I'm coming on strong, she called me. She said, please stay away. You. But I would walk with her to the gate. Nobody can stop me. That's the gate. That's the government road. She took fire. The members of staff told her, where are you going with he? He's a dunce. We're going with that stinking Calypso and he's a dunce. The boy don't even have one subject. I said, yes, she has 9. I have 0. 9 plus 0 are? The girl took fire. But she looked at me and she saw ambition. Yes, somebody
yes,
say
yes,
amen.
Yes, yes, yes.
Because watch it. When you come to Christ, man, it's not how you start, it's how you finish.
Yes, man, yes, yes. Amen, amen.
When you give your life to Christ, Christ has a way of lifting you up. Come on, somebody say
amen. Amen, amen, amen. Yes, man.
When I sang Calypso, I sang in St. Vincent. I sang in Barbados, in the Grenadines. Nowhere else was to come to Trinidad in Sparrow 10. Never reached. God says, if you give me your heart and you keep my Sabbath,
yes,
I'll
man.
Cause you to rise
on the high places. Yes, man.
Come on, somebody say amen,
amen. Amen, amen.
And so I've been preaching. I went to Africa, South America. Is anybody here?
Amen,
North
amen.
America, England, Panama. Is anybody
here? Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, man. We're listening. Yes.
God knows how to get it done.
Amen, amen.
You just got to learn to put your hand. Come on, somebody
amen,
say
amen. Amen, amen.
Oh, put your hand in the hand of the man who stilled the water. Sing with me, please. Oh, put your hand in the hand of the oh, who calms the sea. Take a look at yourself and you can look at others differently. By putting your hand, come on, put your hands together. Come on, everybody, put some volume on the mic, come on. Put your hand in the hand of the man who stilled the waters. Put your hand in the hand of the man who calmed the sea. Take a look at yourself, and you can look. By putting your hand in the hand of the man from Galilee.
Come on,
somebody say amen.
Amen.
Come on, put your hands together for Jesus, somebody.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
God is ready to bless you. Nobody can stop you.
Yes, man. True, true, true.
You hear me?
True, true.
Amen. Came down to Trinidad here, making my appeal just now. To go to college. I dance like bat. All it is that I'm willing.
Yes.
You. For we came down, they promised us a place at the marriage complex. When I came down, not a thing. You listening? Put me in a little room, my wife and myself and my nephew. God was with me, man.
Amen, amen.
Started working in the press for $5 an hour. Big man like me, big man like me. With a wife to take care of. And a mother at home, I still have to pay the bills.
Yes, yes.
Left St. Vincent, a production manager of a newspaper company. But I'll never forget the day. I was by the guillotine cutting some paper and I was singing the song. Don't leave me by myself. I have nobody else to comfort me when darkness surrounds me. Don't leave me by myself. I have nobody else to comfort me when darkness surrounds me. Don't leave me by myself. The next day, Isaac Muhammad called me. Well done. Got the boss's job. Became the production manager.
Yes, man.
From $5 to $13 an hour.
Amen, amen, amen.
With the free apartment sobers, wall to wall carpet.
Praise the Lord, praise the Lord.
Had the college bus. Is anybody listening
to me? Yes, man, yes.
I was able to pay my school fee, send money home to pay mommy's bill and rent and send. Let me tell you something, man. When you stand up for God, God stand up for you.
Yes, man, yes, man. Praise the Lord. Always, always.
I believe that.
What are some of the lessons we can learn from the story of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego? Number one, history will repeat itself.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
They will punish us because we decide to worship on God's Sabbath.
Amen, amen.
Am I speaking the truth here?
Yes, man, yes.
What is the next lesson we can learn? Put it here, please. Babylon will use force in the great conflict between good
and evil. Yes, sir, yes.
What's the next lesson? Put it here. We will be tried and tested as it relates to the law.
Yes, man, yes.
What's the fourth one? Men will trample the law of God.
All right.
And that is happening right here in Trinidad and Tobago.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Number five. Put number five, man. There are people who will be willing to give their lives for their conviction.
Oh, yeah. So true. So true. Yes, man.
And the final one here. Jesus.
Never leaves us.
Come on, somebody talk to me now.
Yes, man. Yes, sir.
Come on, somebody talk to me, man.
Amen. Amen.
Jesus never leaves us
in the fire. Yes, man. True.
Tonight, the choice is yours. Will you reject error and follow what the Bible says is truth? If you reject error and follow what the Bible says is truth, won't you say amen?
Amen, amen.
Tonight the choice is yours. Will you follow Jesus, the man of truth, or obey Satan, the father of lies?
Jesus.
If you'll follow Jesus, why don't you stand to your feet? If you'll follow Satan, you can sit down. Bow your heads, please. Bow your heads, please. Father, I have preached again tonight. Preach a message of courage. Because it takes courage to stand for Jesus. Now, God, I'm going to make an appeal. I'm going to appeal to those who came here Sunday night and Tuesday night, which was last night. And those from last Sabbath who missed the baptism, those who signed up but didn't get baptized. I'm appealing to them. Help them, oh God, to come quickly, to run to this altar.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And after that, Lord, after they have come, I'm going to pray again and appeal to the next class of people. And so you came up on Sunday night and on Tuesday night. I want you to come now. Come, please. Come fast. Run to the altar. Run to the altar, please. Come. Run to the altar. You came up Sunday night and Tuesday night. And you should have been baptized last Sabbath, but you missed the train. Come on, run to the altar, man. Come on, come with speed here. Come fast, man. Come fast. When you're coming to Jesus, man, you come with excitement. Come to Jesus, man. Come. You signed up one of my cards. Come. 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 If they are standing near to you and you know that they signed it up, let them come. Come. Come on down. Give me a second, partner. I'll talk to you after. Okay? All right. Thanks. Thanks. Thank you, man. Talk to you after. I remember. Come. Come. You came up during this week. Come. 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 There are still many more. Where you are? Walk out of those seats. Walk out of those seats. If they are standing near to you, come on, tug them and say, the pastor's calling you. Let me say it again. Maybe you didn't hear me. You came to the altar on Sunday night. You came to the altar on Tuesday night. You signed up one of my cards. I want you to come tonight. Last Sabbath, you should have been baptized, but you missed the train. One thing you don't do with Jesus, you don't make a vow and turn back. So come now. I say to come. I'm spelling the name salvation. I'm spelling the word salvation. Then I'm going to close. Pastor Charles, get ready. Bible workers, get ready to surround these people. Who will come at S? Samuel. Sandra. Samantha. Simon. Who will come at S? If your name begins with S, God says come. Come. Who will come at S tonight? God bless you as you come. God bless you, young boy. God bless you. God bless you. Salvation starts with S. Seek ye the Lord while he may be found. God bless you, sir. Come on, somebody say amen. Amen. Somebody say amen. Amen. Salvation starts with S. I think I see somebody else coming. Am I seeing true? Am I seeing correctly? God bless you. After S is A. Anthony. Andrew. Agatha. Come. Annie. Come. If your name begins with A, God's calling you. God is calling you. He says, ask, and it shall be given. Seek, and he shall find. Knock. God bless you as you come. Who'll come at A? Am I seeing somebody? Am I seeing somebody? Don't tell me my eyes are fooling me here. God bless you as you come. God bless you as you come. S-A-L. Lawrence, Laverne, Lime, Lisa, Leslie, Listra, come. If your name begins with L, come. The Bible says, love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy mind. Is somebody coming? God bless you as you come. Yes, my sister, come. God is calling you. Come. 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 S-A-L. V. Vernice. Veronica. Vicky. Vincent. Vicky, I see you. Give me an Indian name. Virakat. Vishnu, God bless you as you come. Vashti, God bless you as you come. God bless you as you come. Oh, the song says, victory is mine. Victory is mine. Victory tonight is mine. I told Satan, get thee behind. Victory tonight is mine. one more time.
Victory is mine.
S-A-L-V. Is that somebody coming there? Is my eyes fooling me? S-A-L-V. A again? Andy. Andrew. Amos. Anthony. Aaron. 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 Come. April. Amanda. Adam. Adam in the garden.
Hiding.
Adam.
Hiding.
Adam.
Hiding.
Yeah.
Adam in the garden.
Hiding.
Oh,
hiding. Hiding from the Lord.
Hey.
Talisha,
Trevor, Tivon, come. Hallelujah. If your name begins with T, come. Come on, somebody shout hallelujah. 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 If your name begins with T, come. 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 Come tonight. Come. If your name begins with T, come.
Tony.
Tony. Tanti. Tanti.
Yeah.
Come. Come, Tanti, come. Dance. God bless you as you come. Come. Come.
Tanti.
If your name begins with T, come. God bless you as you come. God bless you as you come. Are you weary? Are you heavy-hearted? Tell it to Jesus. Tell it to Jesus. Are you grieving over joys departed? Tell it to Jesus.
Alone.
I still call in tea. Tell it to Jesus.
Tell it to Jesus.
Is a friend that's well known. Aye, aye, aye. You know other, such a friend or brother. Tell it to Jesus alone. One more time, sing it. Tell it to Jesus. Tell it to Jesus. He is a friend that's well known. Ah, you know. Such a friend or brother, tell it to Jesus alone. S-A-L-V-A-T. I, somebody come in at I. Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen.
Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen.
Come on, Ingrid.
Yeah.
Indira.
Yeah.
Ian.
Ishmael.
Isaac. Isaac Muhammad, come. Ishmael, if your name begins with I, come, come, come. Israel, come.
Into my heart, into my heart.
Sing it.
Come into my heart, Lord Jesus. Come.
God bless you. Oh, hallelujah. God bless you, my sister.
Come into my heart, Lord.
Can we sing it one more time? One more time. One more time, show me. Come on, come on.
Yeah. into my heart.
Come on, lift your hands, lift your hands.
Into my heart. Come into my heart. Lord Jesus, come in today. Come in to stay.
God bless you as you come tonight. Young people,
my heart, Lord Jesus.
Come, young people, come. Come, young people. That be your last chance. S-A-L-V-A-T-I, Lord. Oh. O'Neill. Otnell, Omri. If your name begins with O, come. Come. Olivia, come. This is no joke, you know. This is serious. Come. Come. If your name begins with O, come. S-A-L-V-A-T-I-O. Nadia. Nadine Nelsia. Neil Nedra. Narayim, come. If your name begins with N's, God is calling. And then S-A-L-V-A-T-I-O-N. How you spell that?
Salvation.
If you want salvation, come.
Praise.
If you want salvation, come to me. Oh, you can go to heaven with. Come now.
S-A-L-V-A-T-I-O-N.
Oh, you can go to heaven with salvation.
S-A-L-V-A-T-I-O-N.
Come now, come now.
Shout it out.
Like a prisoner.